today we brought a case where, as you can see in this x-ray in this CT, that the patient had a bridge, a metal bridge, on two teeth. The teeth with extensive caries, extraction needed without a question. And you can see that from the teeth, almost nothing left. It just can take out the bridge, probably with two fingers. And in this case, you need to have some kind of restoration. So the first thing we want to do is we can place implants where in the bone where we don't have the teeth. And we have quite good enough bone for two implants here and one implant here. It will be enough for this kind of restoration. So as you can see, this is the metal bridge. The bridge has in the buccal part a little bit of ceramics. Maybe some part of the ceramics broke.
Yeah, it's broken, right? It's not supposed to be
like this. Yeah, it's a
little
bit broken, it's a little bit worn off. This bridge was made a long time ago. This is what's left from the teeth.
Yeah, not much. Yeah,
not much, as you can see.
And the bone is okay, right?
Yeah, the bone is okay, which is quite surprising because in many cases when the bridge is without any pressure, when the bone without any pressure and don't have teeth or implants, you have some bone resorption. So in this case, the fact that we have enough bone is surprising, and surprising in the good meaning. So we placed three implants. We placed two implants in between the teeth that we extracted, and one implant mesially to the tooth. One implant in near tooth number 14.
This is an implant level scan abutment, the first.
Yeah, those are implant level scan abutments. You can see the difference between the different multi-units that we used. This multi-unit is a V-type multi-unit. You can see the line on the scan abutment. And this is the D-type multi-unit. So beneath this scan abutment, it can be either
angulated
multi-unit or straight one. In this case, in here, we probably have an angulated multi-unit because the angulation of the bone is going to the buccal part. And this is an anterior tooth. It's the tooth number 14. So you'll have the screw channel in the buccal part of the crown. And this is something that you don't want to have because of the aesthetical part. And those two multi-units are more posterior. You don't see the screw channel, and it's much simpler to have a restoration on straight multi-units.
Even with such a big angle?
Yeah, even with such a big angle, when you're using multi-units V-type, you can use straight multi-units when you have a little bit bigger angulation. It still fits and everything fine.
Because it has a smaller cone?
Yeah, because it has smaller cone, you can fit even when you have a 30 or 40 degrees angulation. You can see the multi-units and the healing caps. You can see that on tooth number 14, we have an angulated multi-unit, and the other two multi-units are straight V-type multi-units with a small cone. We have the healing caps on the multi-unit. In here, you can see that the original angulation of the angulated multi-unit will be quite extremely angulated, and you'll have the screw channel right in the middle of the tooth. So that's something you don't want to have because it will be problematic in the aesthetical aspect of the restoration. So we used the angulated multi-unit, even though that you can see some part of the multi-unit outside of the gingiva. With angulated multi-units, the biggest problem is that you have the buccal bulge.
Why didn't you use a V-type here as well?
You could use a V-type, but in the meaning of the angulation, if you'll use a straight multi-unit, you can still mill the bridge and you can fit it and everything will be fine. But you'll have the screw channel in the middle of the tooth. So this is a problem that you don't want to deal with because it's quite an aesthetical problem. And it's much bigger problem than a little bit of anodized titanium is coming out of the gingiva. So it's much easier to handle with the little bit of buccal bulge that you can see than the screw channel in the middle of the tooth.
So you said using a straight multi-unit will make an aesthetical problem.
Yeah.
Why not to use this implant as a stopper?
You can use a multi-unit and stopper, but with this big span of a bridge, you'll have three crowns in the air. It's something that can be problematic with different forces applied on the bridge. And either way, you'll have a compromise. Mm-hmm. So the question is, what is the smallest compromise or the easiest to deal with compromise that you'll have? In this case, the smallest compromise is the buccal bulge that you see, and you'll, in this way, you'll have a good bridge. It will hold and won't break. You don't fear that it will break, so it's not a problem. It's not such a big problem. If you'll have a stopper, it can break, and if you have a straight multi-unit, then you'll have a screw channel in the middle of the tooth. That's something that it's hard to deal with.
This is after the healing process.
Yeah, after the healing process, you can see a little bit of plaque mm-hmm. that needs to be clean. And right now, what we're gonna do is take out the healing caps, two compressions, and make the bridge. Mm-hmm. So in this case, we made a bridge from a monolithic zirconia. You can see different type of sleeves. One sleeve is for the angulated multi-unit and two other sleeves are for the straight multi-units.
This is the V-type sleeves and this one is the D-type.
Right. Yeah, this is the angulated D-type sleeve and those two are the V-type sleeve multi-units. Those are the multi-units, as we said. This is the angulated one that the angulation is, the implant is angled this way. And in here we mounted the final restoration. We closed the holes and with a big burr, we polished the...
Why the big burr? Why not just standard burr?
You have a large contact point and it's much easier to get a nicely smooth finish with the bigger burr.
And this is a zirconia, this is the final restoration.
Yes, this is the final restoration from zirconia for this case.
And this is the little bit of the titanium.
Exactly. This is a little bit of titanium that you can see, but you see that it's not such a big problem.
Yeah, it's almost, you really need to check inside his mouth to notice it. Thank you very much for being with us today.
You're welcome.
And thank you for being with us. Don't forget to share, like, subscribe, and follow to stay tuned up to date. Thank you and have a great day.